Good evening, everyone. My name is Minas Dasigenis. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Western Macedonia at the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. Here, I'm going to present the results of a research project that I supervised in my laboratory of robotics embedded and integrated systems. And this was funded by the regional of West Greece in a RIS project. This is the outcome of a 2 years project. A lot of people worked on this because, as I'm going to show, we created a robot from scratch. We didn't use any robot that is ready on the consumer. We designed our own robot, and a lot of expertise was gained as a result. The topic of the presentation is this emotionally intelligent robot from primary education. As we all know, robotics has entered the schools. We saw presentations before about competitions, about skills that are required for the pupils, students, professor to use and expand. In this area, we decided to add our own robot because we saw that there is, even though there are a lot of robots, most of them are expensive and a few of them are open source. We decided to create an open source, an open hardware robot that professors can use, can 3D print, can construct, and can program. Initially, when I thought about this idea, was to create a robot for everyone, for students to learn, for professors to teach as a tool. And this is the result. This is the robot that we created. As I told you, there are a lot of robots outside, but most of them are very expensive. Our robot has a low cost. We utilize the COTS methodology, custom of the self parts, like Raspberry. And for this reason, we keep the cost low. We designed a wheeled robot. It has two wheels in order to move freely in a classroom. And it has also a free wheel at the back in order to keep the balance. This robot started from the sketch. As I told you, we designed from the scratch this robot. I had my team designed expertise, a person that was on the industrial design, and after a lot of discussion, we created these sketches. It's a 60-centimeter robot with wheels, with hands that can move, that can raise hands, that can raise an object. The head can move using a pan tilt mechanism. It has a camera, and it has a 7 inches screen. So it has two wheels, two independent motors, using the proper motor driver, of course, guide this robot according to the professor's needs. The sketches is the first part. A lot of sketches were designed, and some of them were evaluated for the next step, which is the CAD design. We use the Autodesk Fusion 360 software, which is free for academic use. And we designed all these parts, because there are a lot of parts on this robot, to be 3D printed in our laboratory. We have a Prusa MK3 3D printer that utilizes PLA as the manufacturing plastic at 270 Celsius degrees, 65 Celsius degrees for the bed, and it's a direct drive 3D printing machine. We printed a lot of this, all of these components, but some of them we have to redesign it because we found out that the tolerances weren't as tight as we would like to be. And so some parts were designed. We went back to the design board. We designed again and improved these components. We 3D printed again. And finally, we reached our milestone to have a fully 3D printed robot that has moving head, moving head, moving hands, and it has two wheels. As I told you, it's 60 centimeter robot. The weight is 15 kilograms. One person, the professor, can carry this. It has a handle in the back, so he can grasp the robot and move it to the classroom. And it can use it via an Android mobile application that we have created or a website. This is the actual photograph of the robot. It's 3D printed. As I told you, it has a touchscreen of 7 inches, which displays the graphics. Also has speakers, which playbacks audio clips. It has a camera, it has a microphone. It has a sensor on both hands, on the left hand, on the right hand. It has a central button that it's RGB, and according to the programming, it can have different colors, and it's pushable. The student or the professor can push it and triggers the action. And it has also infrared sensors in order not to fall from the desk. If this robot is placed on the desk, it will detect if there is nothing to move and it will stop. As I told you, it has a Raspberry 4 inside, which carries the Linux operating system. We program the robot mainly with Python, but as you know, Linux has support for many programming languages, so it can be programmed with C, for example. And it has also a battery, a Lion battery, and it has a charging contacts that you can easily charge it without opening the cases and taking out the battery. And it has, of course, wireless capability to connect to the network. As I told you, a lot of expertise was required. For example, one of my team members was a PCB designer, specially designed a PCB using Eagle. This is the photograph from the Eagle software that designs PCB, which we send it to Eurocircuits in order to be fabricated. This is a real photograph of the final PCB that was installed inside the robot. This PCB was required in order, as a motherboard, in order to connect all the components. As you can see, it has a number of jumpers that all the sensors and actuators are connected there, because as we saw from some experiments, cable tend to go out from every connector and causes malfunction. In order to have a secure design that it can be moved freely to other places, we had to create a small motherboard. And this was an actual printed motherboard that it was placed inside the robot. As we can see, it has a 40-pin terminal using a 40-pin cable that connects to the main Raspberry component. It has USB ports to provide power. It's not a data USB port. It's only for power, for delivering power to 5-volt devices. It has connectors for providing other voltages. And of course, we have fuse in order to prevent any malfunction. This is a detachable fuse. It can break if an overcurrent is produced by the battery, and we can easily replace it. As I told you, except the hardware, we also develop the software. The software for the robot, for the Raspberry, it runs on Python and PyQTaf. It's the toolkit for providing graphics. And also, using PyGame, we have created some games. When the robot starts, initializes, this screen appears, which is a touch screen. The professor can press the icons and triggers the actions that every icon is connected. The professor can add scripts to this robot in order to be executed. In our experiments, we created some scripts that were given as a textual representation by Professor Bratitzis and his team from a pedagogical school in Florida. in Florida, and we programmed the Python that executed these scripts. For example, one script was to provide the bullying effect, to show to the students how a robot imitating a naughty boy can make some bullying to other pupils. And so the robot was a bit aggressive. It had graphics that showed a bit of aggression. It was moving towards the boys using a bit of aggressiveness. Of course, it was under control, the whole experiment. It was the professor, and he could terminate this if it was out of control. But this was a nice example to show to the pupils how a bad boy can behave and what can be done about this. Or another experiment that was performed was this robot to tell a story about a future pollution. And this was supposed to be a robot coming from 2050 and said, in the future, we have climate problems so large that we cannot even drink pure water. And it had some dystopian pictures that showed. And this triggered discussions about the pupil, how to do, what can do now to protect the environment. This was environmental environmental action. And the students, the pupils, discussed about recycling and other effects. And we can say that it was a very successful experiment. As I told you, we also have a website. The robot connects to the website. It can take some scripts to be executed. For example, we have created Python scripts. The professor can upload the Python script to the website, and this is transferred to the robot. The Python script will, for example, read some sensors, perform some actions, have some graphics and some clips. All these are documented because it has a proper way of creating the scripts. You have to read what are the main functions, what are the requisites of creating the scripts, and what functions of the Python language are supported. The professor uploads the script, this is transferred to the robot, and the robot plays the script. This is the website, it uses secure communication. And the other software, as I told you, is an Android mobile application where the professor can use his mobile phone and telecontrol the robot. He can see from the camera what this robot sees, he can move the robot around, he can instruct it to play some sounds. And this is for another type of experiment where there is no authority in the room, the professor is not in the room, it has left the robot alone, there are pupils there, and he can monitor the reactions of the pupils to this robot, and he will be in the next room to make this telekinesis, telecontrol. And we plan to perform more experiments for the ASD deficiencies, autistic problems for the pupils. Of course, due to COVID, we're not able to perform the number of experiments that we would like. We only performed one experiment using the environment, as I told you, which is going to be published soon in an MDPI journal. We are performing some minor revision and it will be soon be published. And we want to extend this to perform more experiments. And when the project finishes in 1 or 2 months, we will deliver all the hardware and software code schematics for everyone to 3D print, make the connections, create all this, the PCB and everything that's required to use it on his classroom or to start playing with it, because it's a fully functional robot. Someone using Python can easily program it. This is our the robot. This was the project. It provides a better educational experience from the trainees. It has many capabilities. It can be easily programmed by Python. And the teachers, we hope for everyone to adopt it and perhaps extend it. We would like to see somewhere a community using this tool. We created 10 scenarios that, as I told you, one of those was the bullying scenario. It's a cost affordable robot for everyone. Thank you for your attention.
Mr. Carbonides, your sound.
Thank you for the observation. Any questions to Professor Dasigiannis?
Yes, I would like to ask something. First of all, just to point out that this all looks quite impressive. I mean, the whole construction. I would like to ask about the basic operations of the robot. I mean, you already said that it can move, it can actually follow a sound source and move towards it. Regarding its functions, what else it can do? I mean, it can avoid obstacles, it can actually follow a light source. Or, this is what I would like to ask.
Well, regarding basic operations. The functionalities are all connected with the programming. We have connected infrared sensors, we have connected microphone, touch sensors at the hands, it can move the hands. So it's up to the programmer of how to use it. We deliver with the robot 10 scripts that perform some basic actions. But as I told you, it's up to the programmer to see if he will utilize the infrared sensor, for example, or if he will move the hands or if follow the sound. We don't provide any tutorial how to use Python and process input, because it's free. You, in the internet, you can find a lot of sources. We provide the platform, and the programmer has to search a bit on the Google of how to utilize the Python and the sensors together.
About the sensors, it already has in. It can also avoid obstacles, for example, during its movement.
Well, it has infrared sensors, and you can program it to avoid obstacles. The basic setup, it's a bare metal which runs Linux operating system. So you have to add a bit of functionality, extra functionality for this.
Congratulations again.
Thank you.
Any other question?
Can I ask something?
Definitely do. Yeah?
I would like to ask, because I didn't get it quite well. You said that you are going to give your work to teachers. You mean the designs in order for them to print it? Or yes. You are going to... The robot itself.
No, not the robot itself. We are going to create a GitHub repository, and we are going to place all the 3D printing components, all the software, the Eagle layer files in order someone perhaps to expand it or just send it to the manufacturing to create the PCB. Everything for someone to download and create his own robot. We are not going to give completed robots to teacher. We are going to give all the knowledge of how to 3D print and design their own robot.
Okay, thank you.